Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I am Minister Cynthia Forbes. We invite you to tune in to the Tobago Inspirational Network for the message of hope. Greetings in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I welcome you to another message. Hallelujah, the message of hope. Another time where we spend in the Word of God. Amen. For a brief moment, time flies. Amen. Last time we were together, we looked at the Gospel of John, chapter 18, 28 to 40, where it reads, Then cried they all again, not this man, but Barabbas. Now Barabbas was a thief, and I focused on this man. Last time we tried to see who this man is, this man. And we recognize this man is Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. And we went through some of the names that he carried. Only just a few. He's so much and is that much and so much more. Amen. But before we go into today's activity, Lord, we want to pray and ask God to have his way. Hallelujah. Father God, I give you praise and I give you thanks for your goodness. Thank you, O God, for your mercy. Thank you for another opportunity to share your word, whatever it might be. You use me as your vessel today. Minister through me. Speak through me, O God, to say what you would have me to say. Bless the hearts of those who view this program, O God. In the name of Jesus, I pray, God, that souls would be saved as a result of hearing your word. Hallelujah. Those who have gone before, those who have had to come, my God, let the word continue to go forth without let and hindrance, my God. Convict, convince, convert, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 oh God. Have your way, it's still not your will that any should perish, but that all, oh God, all should come to repentance. I pray, God and Father, spirit of repentance will come over many today as they fall on their knees before you in repentance. Hallelujah, asking for your forgiveness. Hallelujah, asking you to come into their lives and to cause them to be born again, to experience new life in Christ. Oh God, just have your way today across the nations of the world, in Trinidad and Tobago, in every home, every family, in every office today, in every school, oh God, wherever man may be found today, minister according to your divine will and purpose. In Jesus' name I pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen and amen. Praise God. So I will not read the whole of the verses from 28 to 40. All right, I'm still focusing on verse 40. Of John's Gospel, chapter 18, that reads, Then cried they all again, saying, Not this man, but Barabbas. Amen. Now Barabbas was a robber. What was happening here is Jesus's trial before Pilate. When Pilate, and we know the account, but nothing is wrong with repeating it. Let it sink into your ears, into your spirit. When Pilate decided to release Jesus, hallelujah, the mob cried out, not this man, hallelujah, but this man is a man above all men. They didn't want Jesus Christ. They wanted Barabbas, hallelujah. But it was all in God's plan to bring about eternal redemption for the world. Amen. So we looked at who was this man, and we found out this man, they were referring to him as this man, no ordinary man. It's Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Amen. And I remember I shared that you need this man. We all need him. Whether you like it or not, whether you believe it or not, you know, sometimes we live as though we are our own bosses. We are here on our own accord. All that we achieve is on our own accord. Hallelujah. But we all need this man called the Christ. Hallelujah. And I propose to you, I put it to you today and to all of us, that you need this man. I need this man. We all need this man because of who he is. Hallelujah. Not just was, who he is, because he is alive. Amen. And because of what he has done. Amen. And what he can do for you and for me. Amen. So we want to look today at Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, what he has done. Amen. You know, John, in at the end of his the gospel said there were so many things that Jesus Christ had done. Hallelujah. That were not written in the book that he was writing, John, in the gospel, that if they were to be written and to give an account of all that Jesus Christ had done, the world could not hold the books. Amen. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In John chapter 9 and verse 4, Jesus declared, I must work the works of him that sent me. You see, Jesus Christ was sent into this world. That's why John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave. He sent his son. He gave him. Hallelujah. I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day, for the night cometh. Hallelujah. When no man can work. Amen. So Jesus knew he had a work to be done. He came to do a work. Hallelujah. And as somewhere in the Old Testament, we read that the king's business requires haste. And Jesus had just approximately 3.5 years to complete the work that he was given to do. Hallelujah. I read when he said to his parents, as a matter of fact, when he asked them at 12 years old, when they went looking for him, hallelujah, and they found him in the temple among doctors and lawyers answering their questions and asking them questions. And they were so astonished at his knowledge, how he could answer things. Amen. And when they asked him, why you have us looking for you? We were wondering what happened to you. We were so hurt and so sorrowing for you. And he asked them, don't you know, mom, dad, don't you know that I must be about my father's business? Amen. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus came to do a work, a quick work. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. While he was on earth, he was referred as an incessant worker. Hallelujah. There was never a dull moment. Hallelujah. In the life of Jesus Christ, whether he was being harassed by the scribes and the Pharisees, or he was being thronged by the people, hallelujah, or they called upon him for one reason or the other. There was never a dull moment, hallelujah, in the life of our Lord Jesus Christ, amen, while he was on earth. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Was soon coming king. Hallelujah. Let me splice in here. He's coming again, you know. Hallelujah. He is coming again. Hallelujah. The word again means he was here already. He left the earth and he's coming again. Be prepared. Amen. Hallelujah. His work or his ministry began early in the morning. Hallelujah. Even before it was day. A great while before day, we read, hallelujah, in Mark 1:35, hallelujah, Jesus rising up early, a great while before day, and he would pray, hallelujah, praying his work, hallelujah, praying his work. Jesus did nothing before he prayed. He always prayed before he did anything, hallelujah. And so we too, we must take time out to pray, get the wisdom of God. Hallelujah. Get his direction. Hallelujah. Before we do anything, sometimes we do not. We do things first and then want to pray after. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Then we have in John 8 and verse 2. Hallelujah. It was early in the morning when Jesus Christ went to the temple and they brought this woman, they said, who was taken in adultery and tossed her on the steps. Hallelujah. So that they could have stoned her to death according to the law. Early in the morning, Jesus began his day basically with prayer. Hallelujah. 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 And he continued work until night or late in the evening. Hallelujah. In Matthew 8 and 16, Hallelujah. The sick were brought unto him in the late evening. Hallelujah. Sick, the disease, the maimed, the lame, they were brought unto him. So his mourning, he began in the morning and continued until the evening, even until in the night. Hallelujah. According to Mark 6 and 12. Hallelujah. Praise the name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. He would pray all night. Hallelujah. He would have all night prayer meeting. Hallelujah. Meet with his father all night because he had a work to do. He couldn't do it in his own strength, in his own might, or in his own power. Hallelujah. He needed God. He needed the anointing. He needed the power of God. He needed the wisdom of God. He didn't depend on his own strength and ability and own wisdom. He needed direction from his father. So early in the morning, he would pray. During the day, he would work until in the evening. And in the night, he continued, hallelujah, as he spent time before his father. Hallelujah. An incessant worker. Hallelujah. He's called. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. John chapter 3 and verse 2 tells us Nicodemus, he had an encounter with Jesus Christ. It was in the night. Hallelujah. There was no rest for this man. Hallelujah. Even while he took a rest, he would be awakened to attend to somebody's need. Amen. Nicodemus met with Jesus Christ in the night after a hard day's work. And when you think he will get some time out, hallelujah, there was a knock on the door. The knock on the door, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And like the good servant of his father, he would not refuse. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He would attend to whatever need the person had. Hallelujah, blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and our Father in heaven. Jesus's work consisted basically of, for example, teaching. Hallelujah. Teaching. Basically, teaching from Matthew chapters 5 to 7. Hallelujah. Chapters 5, the whole of chapter 5 to chapter 7. On the mountain, hallelujah, where he gave the Beatitudes, hallelujah. Whether it was on a mountain top or by the seashore or as he traveled along the way or whether it was out of a ship, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Whether it was in a ship or in somebody's house, hallelujah. Jesus taught the people. He taught the people, hallelujah, about the kingdom of God, his father, the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God. What it is, not what it was, what it is, hallelujah, and how they can enter into his kingdom, to his father's kingdom. So teaching was part of his job, hallelujah, hallelujah, and he didn't shirk from it, hallelujah. In spite of what the scribes, the Pharisees, and those who didn't like him, in spite of what they said or what they did, hallelujah, what they thought about him, he continued, hallelujah, because he knew he came to do a work, and it was a quick work, just a couple years, hallelujah, he had to get it done. Amen. Time. He had time to do it. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Not only did Jesus teach, he also preached. Hallelujah. Preaching an assignment. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He preached the gospel of the kingdom of God. In John chapter 1 and verse 14, you'll find that. In Mark chapter 1 and verse 38, he preached the kingdom. Hallelujah. The gospel. Hallelujah. The message of the kingdom. Hallelujah. The kingdom of God. How to get into it. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Included in his ministry was, or in his work, bringing the dead back to life. Hallelujah. My God, the physical dead and the spiritually dead. Hallelujah. Quickening the spirit. Hallelujah. We read of Lazarus in John chapter 11, verse 43. Hallelujah. After Lazarus was already buried, hallelujah, he was able to bring him back to life. We read of Jairus' daughter. Hallelujah. When Jairus went to him, hallelujah, and he was thronged by the people, he was kept back. But Jesus knew, message came to Jairus saying, look, don't bother Jesus anymore. Your daughter is dead. Jesus said, hey, don't worry, just believe. You don't worry. Because Jesus knew what he would do. He had the power to bring her back to life. Amen. So that's Jairus' daughter. And then there was the widow of Nain. She was on her way to bury her son. Hallelujah. And Jesus was passing by right at the moment. He was there right on time. And Jesus is an on time, right on time person. Hallelujah. Then and now. Amen. You find that in Matthew chapter 9 and verse 25. Hallelujah. On her way to bury. Hallelujah. What are you on your way to bury today? Hallelujah. Jesus is passing your way. Hallelujah. He could give life to that which you want to bury. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. 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 My God, my God, my God. Your marriage. Hallelujah. What are you burying today? Your talent, your skill, your abilities. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Your hope, are you going to bury your hope? Hallelujah. Let Jesus quicken you today. Hallelujah. He's passing your way. Hallelujah. Also healing the sick. His work entailed healing the sick. Listen, and all along his journey, all of that was pointing to one place. He was on a journey. He was on a journey. And as he's going, journeying to the cross, all these things he had to do, hallelujah, on his way to the cross. Healing the sick, Matthew 8 and 9, hallelujah. The centurion's servant, hallelujah, who came to him, sent to him, my servant is sick, come and heal him, hallelujah. And as Jesus was going, the centurion said, no, it's okay, you don't have to come into my house. Hallelujah, for I am a man under authority. Hallelujah. All you have to do is speak the word. Hallelujah. If you have faith today, hallelujah, let Jesus speak into your situation. Cause him to talk to you, talk into your situation. Give life to whatever you're going through. Give life to what you count dead. Hallelujah. He can resurrect it for you today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The woman with the issue of blood, 12 years. Hallelujah. And the palsied man, the man who was sick of a palsy. Yeah? Jesus was able to heal. And there were so many others that came to him for healing. Amen. Not only so, he operated also in casting out demons. Hallelujah. Evil spirits that possessed people. Hallelujah. We think of the man at Gadara. Oh my God. He had legions, hundreds and thousands of demons in him. And Jesus was able to cast out those demons. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. What evil spirit is in you today? Hallelujah. It could be cast out in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. By the power of the Holy Spirit and the anointing of God. Hallelujah. Demons and demonic influences. Hallelujah. My God, my God, my God, can be cast out of your life, from your home, your family, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You got to believe. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Saving the lost. Hallelujah. Oh, my God, my God. We think of Zacchaeus. Hallelujah. The publican working for the Romans whom the people hated. Hallelujah. Jesus saw him and said, I'm coming to your house. Hallelujah. And when in the presence of Jesus, Zacchaeus confessed. Hallelujah. He confessed. Jesus did not ask him anything. Hallelujah. He confessed and Jesus said, today salvation. Hallelujah. It's come to this house. His entire household was saved. Entire household was delivered. Amen. The woman, hallelujah, who was called a sinner. Hallelujah. They called a woman who was a sinner. Everybody was born in sin. They called her a sinner. The one who anointed Jesus' feet. Hallelujah. She got her deliverance. She got her salvation. Hallelujah. The words that Jesus would say is, thy sins be forgiven thee. Hallelujah. Thy sins be forgiven thee. And we read in the Gospels on several occasions where Jesus used these words to individuals. Thy sins be forgiven thee. Hallelujah. Forgiving sin. Hallelujah. Is part of the work of Jesus Christ. Amen. Another thing that Jesus Christ did, an aspect of his work, was to call and train workers. Hallelujah. He, out of multitudes of people, he called, he chose 12 men. Train them. Hallelujah. To take over the work when he would have left. Hallelujah. To take over the work. So he called Matthew 10. You'll find that in Matthew 10 and in Luke 10. Hallelujah. Jesus called and he trained. Hallelujah. And then sent them out in the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. So Jesus came to do a work. He didn't just come on his own mission. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He called people to him. Apart from calling and training, the masses that followed him, those who were laboring and trying to pull up themselves by their own bootstraps to make themselves righteous. Hallelujah. Laboring, doing all sorts of things to find, well, a place with God, as it were. Hallelujah. To please God, to be in God's favor, to enter into his kingdom. We cannot just do things to enter into God's kingdom. Hallelujah. We have to come to Jesus Christ. Come to Jesus Christ. And he called people. Say, come unto me, all ye that labor. And he's still calling. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Come and I will give you rest. Hallelujah. Why people are moving up and down doing this to find peace and to find rest, to find satisfaction, to find comfort. Hallelujah. And looking in all the wrong. And the more we get those things, we've been still not satisfied. We have to go again. We have to do it again. Hallelujah. We have to smoke again. We have to drink again. Hallelujah. To find satisfaction, to find peace. Amen. Jesus did. He gave hope to the hopeless. Hallelujah. Ah, we have a world of hopeless people. Hallelujah. My God, think of the father that, the husband that killed his wife, his children, and himself. No hope. Hallelujah. And there are lots of people in our world today have no hope. No hope. Everything, they come to the edge. They're at the edge, at the brink of life. They don't know what to do next. Hallelujah. Next thing to do is put your life. Hallelujah. Don't know what to do next? Put your life in the hands of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Jesus comforted those who needed to be comforted in their distresses. He would say, weep no more. Hallelujah. Be of good cheer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be of good cheer. My God, my God, my God. Amen. Jesus still storms at sea. Hallelujah. And if there's a storm in your home, it's a storm, you have a stormy relationship. My God, my God. Your family is stormy. Things are stormy. Hallelujah. Jesus can calm the storms if you put your situation in his hands. Amen. Hallelujah. He gave sight to the blind. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He gave speech to the dumb. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hearing to the deaf. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. My God, he wants to make you see not only the physical, not physical only, but spiritual. He wants to open your spiritual eyes. But that could only be done as you give your life to Jesus Christ. Amen. He caused the lame to walk. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. This man that they said, not this man, hallelujah, but Barabbas. Not this man Christ Jesus, in spite of all that he had done. in spite of all that he had done for many of them, some of them, I believe, stood in the crowd, hallelujah, and joined with the others. Not this man, hallelujah. But let us know, we all need this man today, tomorrow, and forever. Hallelujah, hallelujah. My God, not because we are making it in this world. You see, again, making it, it is God who is giving us the strength. Hallelujah, hallelujah, the strength. He woke us up this morning. He woke us up almost every day. Hallelujah, he gave us the strength. He provided the job, hallelujah. The skills and the abilities, the talents that we have, we didn't just get it. They came from him, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, because we achieve, we become affluent, we achieve, we become successful. We think we don't need God, we don't need this Jesus, hallelujah, we don't need this church they're talking about. I don't need to be saved, I have everything I could get, I don't need anything from anybody. Yes, we need him, we need this man because of who he is, because of what he has done. And because of what he can do, we all need him. You, especially for those who have not yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. No, you need him for salvation. You need him to forgive your sin. You need him to cleanse you. You need him to deliver you. We all need that same man, the man that the masses rejected before Pilate. We need Jesus. You need Jesus in your life. And I need him in my life every day. Amen. Today is your day to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Now, continue to read in the Word of God. I cannot give you everything that he would have done. Amen. But continue to read. Go into the Word of God, into the Gospels, and see, hallelujah, what Christ did and what he can do for you. God bless you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Father God, I give you praise and I give you thanks. Thank you for your word. Thank you for reminding us, hallelujah, what your son did, oh God, while he was on earth. Hallelujah, what he's still doing. Hallelujah, because he is alive. He's seated at the right hand of the majesty on high. Amen. He's making intercession for us. He's our mediator, oh God, the go-between man and you, oh God. Hallelujah. Continue to minister your word to those who have viewed this program. Bless it to all our hearts. Let it continue to resonate in their spirits. Save souls today, oh God. Heal sick bodies. Strengthen the weak. Lift up those who have fallen. Bring back those who have wandered away from you into your fold, oh God. In Jesus' name, I pray with thanksgiving. Amen. God bless you. God make his face to shine on you. Accept Jesus Christ today before it is too late. Amen. Praise God. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I am Minister Cynthia Forbes. We invite you to tune in to the Tobago Inspirational Network for the message of hope.